يعني إجمالا الجلسة ما بعد الغداء هي الجلسة الأصعب، رح نحاول نخليها مثيرة ويعني سهلة على الهضم، مع إنه الكلام عن النفط في الشرق الأوسط ليس على الإطلاق سهل الهضم. طبعا يعني كأنه كان ينقص هذه المنطقة المبلية بالحروب والصراعات وإعادة رسم الخرائط وانهيار الأنظمة، وكأنه كان أيضاً ينقص القضية الفلسطينية بتعقيداتها من تعنت إسرائيلي واستيطان وتخاذل عربي وانسحاب غربي مرشح إلى الازدياد الآن مع ترامب. كأنه كان ينقص كل هذه الأمور نقمة النفط والغاز، ما يذكرني بقوي يعني بيت شعر للمتنبي: أبنت الدهري كل بنت عندي فكيف وصلت أنت من الزحامي. يعني كل شيء في عنا مصايب جاي هلأ النفط والغاز. بسمح لحالي سميه مصيبة لأنه بحكم عملي لبعض السنوات في صندوق النقد الدولي تسنى لي أن العمل على الكثير من البلدان النفطية، وأستطيع أن أقول جازما أنه باستثناء حالي أو حالتين بالحد الأقصى كان النفط نعمة وليس نقمة. باستثناء حالي أو حالتين كان نقمة، بحالي أو حالتين كان نعمة، لأن النروج أكيد واحدة منهم ومؤخراً الولايات المتحدة الأمريكية، وبالحالتين الحقيقة أنه كان نعمة وليس نقمة، لأنه كان هناك مؤسسات قائمة فعالة مستقلة تمارس الرقابة والتوازن، أو ما يسموه بالأمريكية checks and balances، فاستطاعت أن تستفيد هذه البلدان من الموارد النفطية وتسخرها لخدمة الاقتصاد ولخدمة الإنسان. طبعاً في عالمنا العربي هذه المؤسسات غائبة، والدول قوية على شعوبها وليس على بمؤسساتها، والمؤسسات الأكثر خبرة وفعالية هي مؤسسات الأمنية ومؤسسات المخابرات وليس مؤسسات الرقابة. مع هذه المقدمة يعني هيك المشجعة لفتح الشهية، على الأقل وبالرغم من هذه النقمة فنحن محظوظون أنه عنا الخبراء الأفضل اليوم ليحكونا على القليل كيف نفهم وضعنا في منطقة الشرق الأوسط لناحية النفط والغاز، وذلك من خلال محاور ثلاث أو جلسات ثلاث. الأولى عن تأخير تطوير حق القطاع حق الغاز مارين، والثانية التطورات الغازية في مصر، والثالثة الصناعة البترولية في إسرائيل والسياسة البترولية الإسرائيلية. ولذلك سوف أطلب الآن من المتحدث الأول الدكتور صالح جلاد من شركة اتحاد المقاولين العالمية إعطائنا مداخلته ب 15 دقيقة. أنا عارف. 15 دقيقة حتى، لأنه هي محطوط 20 بس ما تركين وقت للنقاش. أكل حال إذا بدك 20 تفضل.
هو بدي أخذ دقيقتين سمعيني. بس بدي أخذ دقيقة أقل من دقيقة بس عشان أعلق على إشيين مهمين للمؤتمر ككل. بس اللي أقول كلمة أجد كلمة الحوكمة، وأنا صوت كاتب كتاب عن الحوكمة، وأجد كلمة القيادة، وكمان في عندي كتاب عن القيادة في البلاد العربية. أوكي، ففي هناك نقص، مش نقص، تشويش بالمعاني حتى، لأن الحوكمة هي مش حوكمة بس المايكرو اللي بنعملها هلأ، الحوكمة هي الأصل الفطرية. الكل بيعرف مثلاً أنه الحوكمة فطرياً من ولد صغير أنه المشاركة في القرار، هاي واحد. ثانياً الشفافية في الأداء، وثالثاً وما ضلش غيرهم، ثالثاً المساءلة في النتائج. هدول الثلاثة الذي ينبثق منها القيادة التي يجب عليها الاتصال بهذه الثلاث أعمدة هدول، وإذا لعبوا بالثلاث أعمدة هاي راحت كل شيء تاني. وهذه حال الأمة العربية اليوم ككل، وأيضا في كل بلد عربي بدون استثناء. هاي واحد. واثنين، بدي ألخص للأخ الدكتور ناصر. الدكتور ناصر محاضراته جيدة عظيمة، تتلخص بالآتي: كالعيس في البيداء يقتلها الظمأ والماء فوق ظهورها محمول. فنحن، هذا يلخص الأمة كلها ككل وكل دولة. هاي واحد. أنا اسمحوا لي بليز بدي أحكي بالإنجليزي لأنه أسأل لي هلأ بالنسبة عشان أدخل في الموضوع. و البارادايم اللي ماشي على اللي ذات إسرائيل، the occupation forces civil and military are going through this is not a propaganda, this is really, and I left 2016 because I'm afraid to face the fact as a Palestinian, as an Arab from Palestine, that there will be all of it is white and none of it is those satellites. That these are like the settlements, instead of Israeli settlements, these will be Palestinian settlements. والحبل على الجرار. This is what I wanted to say now. Please, the title of my presentation is Geoeconomics and Geopolitical Occupation, the Case of Palestine's Hydrocarbon Resources. I would like to say that geoeconomics, in its widest definition, represents the most crucial element that underlies the geographic geopolitical dynamics of the ebb and flow of the various world cultures over time and space. Together, they have succinctly formulated the prevailing human civilization. The cyclical nature of history reflects the net behavior of vital geoeconomic and geopolitical undercurrents. Palestine had its share in the past, has it at present, and I am sure will have it in the future as well. But the idea is not Palestine. The Palestine is like Ibn al-Muqaffa said in Kalila wa Dimna, which I translated in 2002, the first ever translation in English from Arabic directly, is Palestine is like a statue where everything is held with one nail. If you pull that nail, the whole statue dismantles. Now, sanctioned by the United Nations, empowered by the industrial countries, and by other organizations, the establishment of the Salafist state of Israel on Palestinian land was the climax of a long set of cloak and dagger and activities developed in the last quarter of the 19th century, and particularly since the imposition of the clauses of the Sykes-Picot Agreement. And next year is 2017 is going to be the 100th memory, and probably our great-great-grandchildren will say 3,000 years ago or 300 years ago, this is the memory of the Balfour Declaration. As long as we are staying like that, without resources. What does Israel want? Just, I will talk about the Gaza, but bear with me, because it is futile for experts, for politicians, and for the public to think that that oil and gas is detached from their welfare today and the welfare of the future generations. And we try, as as economists to say GDP, which you will see now, GDP of Palestine and all this. What does it mean? What does it mean to the people? What does it mean to the individual who lives in this society? How is it fair for that society? These are the cornerstones of the paradigm of al-hawkama, of governance, illi you brag about. Okay? So, what in Palestine today, what is happening is, look, this is the growth, according to standards of the world, which don't fit neither Palestine nor the Arab countries, because all the Arab countries are feudalistic in nature. They own those resources, all the Arab countries, okay, including Palestine. So that issue is reflected in, okay, GDP, but look at the fluctuation, the severe fluctuation in both GDP and population. In Palestine, real GDP increases on 1% per year since 2000, let's say, according to this. Now, population increases by 3%. That tells the whole story, okay? The issue is why, okay? Of course, it is Palestine is infested with underemployment, unemployment, hidden employment. There are figures, there are too much. We don't know whether they are true or not, but at least the direction is right, okay? Our balance of payment is with Israel is only we are a captive economy, okay? Our foreign trade is with one country, which is the occupation forces. The occupation forces, because of the structure of the Oslo Agreement of the Area C is deformation of the Palestinian ecosystem. Deformation of the Palestinian ecosystem. If there was no C, which comprises 61% of the Arab land and productive land of the country called potential country, state of Palestine, all right, then the GDP will increase by $4 billion. And Palestine will not be a begging nation. I'm sorry to say that, but this is the truth, okay? Now, how does Israel, the occupation forces, do that? Occupation forces do it in various ways. Seizure, thieving, everything that you can think of, they are very well, even today you said that Israel had antitrust. Don't believe that. They have other motives. It's not the antitrust. Since when there is antitrust in Israel, okay, for its citizens? But because they have other things in mind, they want to have a lull in the activities, and using as a pretext antitrust. Okay, why I am saying all these things? Because I will talk now about oil and gas. I will try to finish with 15 minutes, as you said. But
15 minutes starting from now, or?
Yeah, thank you. the issue here is that oil and gas is part and parcel of the entire thing in Palestine, and oil and gas and the policies of Israel that it had applied on all resources against international law, against international conventions. I don't want to be a lawyer. It's not my field. Against everything, okay? With various pretexts, just kicking away all standards, okay? International standards, and everybody, including the Arab neighbors and the riparian states or the contiguous state, like Egypt and all other Arab countries, are not helping. We are like, I hope you will understand this proverb in Arabic. أُكِلْتُ يَوْمَ أُكِلَ الثَّوْرِ الْأَبْيَضُ. Because every state is talking about itself. And they don't give a damn about the others because they want their own, which is, I understand. But I understand the folly too, okay? Instead of together, even if we don't have in Palestine borders with Lebanon, we know we have disputes between Lebanon and rightly so, disputes between Lebanon and Israel. Palestine and Lebanon should be together against Israel, okay? And Egypt, I came to the conclusion, I'm going to be very, very frank. I came to the conclusions that even the Arab countries don't want a Palestinian solution. I believe so, I am sorry. But the acts that are going on, and you can criticize me the way you want, okay? The figures, the acts, they show, they clearly veer us, veer me to that conclusion. Now, the slither, where are we? Look at this, this. Everybody finds this as, and don't understand, and don't ask, this is good. This is five times less than what Palestine, according to international law, and according to international conventions, and according to look at this. That part goes towards Cyprus. Every time there is Cyprus, Israel, Cyprus, Egypt, Cyprus, Lebanon, Cyprus. Who is absent? One important contiguous country, potential country, and you claim it is a country, okay, is absent, is given. We are happy with a slither of this. Sorry. This rather than this, up to the point, according to international law, okay? So, are we going to be devoured like now, before the actual devouring of everybody else? Because I tell you something, the weak, the strong will do what they will. The weak will do what they must. And this is our case. It's very important. This is not a propaganda issue. This is real. This is what happened everywhere. Now, if you look at all the issues, all the policies applied by the occupation forces and the civil government, because sometimes according to international law, I'm not a lawyer, I'm an economist, I am my colleagues here, we are in I have MIS, we have in CCC, we were with CCC, Mr. Fawzi Kawash was the chief executive of CCC, okay, and he knows we are the best, one of the best in pipe laying, we know how much. And you say we have no experiences, no. We have the people, but they are not focused. They are not focused. They run away, actually, it's not focused, okay? For various reasons. We have the technology, we have the mind, okay? All right. Now, the Gaza, every single action, every single policy, from cutting the trees, from yesterday having fire in Palestine, burning all the olive trees. Why? There's one issue, okay? The paradigm, the governance that they are following. It's not our governance, their governance is that Palestine is theirs, all of it, okay? Irrespective, and to they don't want, they have enough billions of gas resources. We all know, you have seen that this morning, okay? However, they want to deny against international law, against international charters, the one thing, the right to develop, the human right to develop their resources. Therefore, take their resources. If not, then do the right thing. The right thing as far as, if I were an Israeli, I will do the same thing because I belong to that paradigm. The paradigm is I want this country. If I cannot take it by force, then or by ethnic cleansing, then it will be by creeping economic genocide. And this is what's happened. This is the question. It's not the economics. It is not anything. The economics is easy. The technology is easy. It is there. If it is not there, we can find it. But it is the policies. And if the Arab neighbors, the contiguous or riparian countries, don't stick together, particularly the Arabs, okay, then you will be devoured soon because Israel is stronger than any one of us, and it is stronger internationally. It has a governance system like the mafia. It's the best organization in the world, it's the mafia. It is effective, okay, for a different reason. That is what they have. And am I finished? Thank you. That's enough.
Shukran. شكرا دكتور صالح على هذه المداخلة القيمة والتي يعني هيك سأضعها في يعني إطار عام بما تحدثت به يعني حضرتك